Hi guys, it's Emily here. So welcome back to another speed building video. And this time it's just a 3x3 tiny house. I just wanted to build one for fun. So yeah, hopefully you guys like it. It was quite the challenge. You see me messing around with things a lot and changing my mind a lot and playtesting a lot. So if it's a bit laggy, my computer, like I've mentioned in like the last two videos, I think, it does have a hard time running with, my game recording software and my, just running the gameplay and everything at the same time is a bit hard on my laptop. And yeah, so I did cut out some of the lag, but I may have not caught it all. So hopefully it's not too bad. And yeah, hopefully you guys like this build and you will get to see the welcome wagon. And I had my custom content out of my game at this time. I just removed my mods folder and yeah, it was pretty funny because we have a naked woman show up for the neighborhood greetings or whatever, the welcome wagon. So that was pretty funny. So yeah, you're gonna see that here pretty soon. She shows up rather quickly. But yeah, I'm just playtesting it with a random sim that I just generated. There's the naked lady, there she is, hi! She's been walking around the neighborhood all bald and naked and in her undies. It was funny, so. But anyways, I'm just playtesting things. I end up leaving the bed right up there, and I can't leave the chair down there because I realized that I didn't have enough room to fit a bathroom in if I did, and plus adding a bookshelf and kind of the way I wanted to do it just wasn't going to work, so I wouldn't be able to use the bed, so yeah, unfortunately, but I thought that lamp looked really nice next to that chair, so I'm going to have to remember that for another build, and yeah, as you can see, she's having trouble with everything right now, but yeah, so if you decide to download this, I don't know how much fun it'd be to play in. It was more just fun for me to build. And I mean, your sim could probably live in it for a long time. I mean, it has everything they need, a bathroom, a bed, a refrigerator. There's no stove, but I kind of had in mind that was a mini fridge, which I really hope that we get an actual mini refrigerator. I think that would be really cool. Maybe with the family themed pack that's coming up, if they do some sort of dorm, college thing with that pack, a pretty cool item to add, and I think it would make a lot of sense. So hopefully that we get something like that, because I don't know, you don't need a full-fledged kitchen in a little tiny home like this, at least this tiny. I mean, if we added another square on either side, made it a 4x4, then we might be able to put a reasonable size kitchen in there. But look at this woman, she just won't get out of the house, and I was like, hello, I'm trying to build something, get out of here. And yeah, so hopefully you guys don't mind her. It's pretty funny. Yeah, this is where the bathroom ends up being. It's just kind of, I hid it behind a curtain. I thought that was kind of nice just to make the toilet a little bit more private, and then the shower is blocked off by a half wall, so, or the tallest half wall. So yeah, it's a little bit of privacy for the bathroom, but it's still obviously all one room, and yeah, I think it works out really nicely. She gets a TV in here, a computer desk, a bookshelf, and that's about it for entertainment, which I mean is pretty much all you need besides a radio. And I was going to put one in here and decided to fill up the space with some decoration instead. I think this sink gave me the most trouble, and so you'll see me mess with that for quite a while, but yeah, she just had trouble getting inside the house between the sink and the bookcase. It's just a little too narrow. So I end up putting the sink actually by the toilet, which I don't know why I didn't think of that before. It makes a lot of sense, and yeah, it works out really nicely. So yeah, I think it's pretty cute in the end. I wanted to build it. I was realized that when I had created my channel, I actually created an entire playlist for tiny houses and only ever built one, which is kind of silly. I guess my caravan campground kind of constitutes a tiny home, but I'm more intended that just to be for like camping, so not for somebody to live in. But yeah, I have one house on there. I built it a long time ago. I think there might be commentary over it. It was one of my very first builds, and my first couple I didn't talk over them at all because I was just kind of nervous. And but I think it's definitely important to talk over your videos. But anyway, so it's bigger than this house. It's probably a 5x5, I think is what it is. But I just wanted to build a teepee house. It wasn't really for any particular challenge. This one is definitely challenging because of how small it is. A 3x3 is so tiny. I don't think you could do any smaller than this without, yeah, you couldn't do anything smaller than this, I don't think. I mean, maybe you could, but it would be just like a shower and a bed, and then you'd have to put like a bush and a grill outside, and that's kind of cheating. So I didn't put anything to make food outside, but obviously if you wanted something a little bit more than just a refrigerator, you could put like a barbecue outside and a dining area outside. But I just put a yoga mat and one little chair outside because I didn't want to, I thought that was kind of cheating. So yeah, that's what I decided to do. But yeah, hopefully you guys like this. I hope, I don't know. This is kind of something fun to do. This isn't part of any series or any, you know, me rebuilding any neighborhoods or anything. It's just for fun. I just kind of wanted to do it. And if you want to download it, that'd be great. If you want to share pictures of me, then go ahead. If you want to build your own tiny home, I would love to see, definitely share that with me on Twitter or tell me your gallery name in the description, or not in the description. You can't write the description, in the comments, I mean. Tell me in the comments your gallery ID and I will definitely go check it out if you do build any tiny homes, because I think they're definitely really fun and I love watching people do them and kind of just seeing how they plan out the entire floor plan, because it's like a jigsaw puzzle. It's a pretty fun. But now we're finally getting to decorate it because everything worked. She was able to get to everything. So I put in some flooring and some wallpapers and then changing the bed color because I wanted to do a wall of orange wallpaper. I saw the orange color and I was like, I want to do an orange like feature wall. And so I changed the bed color because it clashed with the green and the pink quite a bit, in my opinion anyway. So yeah, I think it looks really nice. And I hope you guys are having a good day and everything. I'm having a really good day. It's been really sunny and warm here, warmer than I thought it was outside. I went outside to go walk my dog and we ended up going for a jog and it was really nice. And I haven't ran outside in forever and she was so excited to do it. She was like just hauling butt everywhere and I was like, I can't keep up with you. Like, even though, like, when I still lived in Montana, I was pretty sedentary and got pretty out of shape there. But ever since I've been moved back to California, you know, I've been outside a lot more, been a lot more active, got a gym membership. And so I'm not super lazy or anything, but man, when it comes to running outside, that's a whole different world. So she was kicking my butt a little bit, but I should do that more often. It's such a good workout. And yeah, slim up my legs a little bit, which is definitely necessary in my opinion. Yes, that was fun. And I was wearing a sweater and had my hair down, so it wasn't like I wasn't the most put together to go jogging, but I think maybe I'll have to do that here again soon. Definitely, she likes it a lot. But as you can see, things are coming together, just getting things organized. And I do end up putting a trash bin outside when I was taking the screenshots, because I kind of forgot to do that. But there is a bin, you'll see it. Yeah, you'll see it in the screenshots. It's nothing too exciting, it's just right on the side of the house. And there's a little bin inside just because why not, it could fit. So thought I would put it in there. And yeah, I don't think I left anything out that was important. I mean, obviously a stove's pretty nice to have, but cereal and yogurt, your Sims can last on that for a while before it gets annoying. And like I said, you could add a barbecue grill outside and they can, you know, make tons of food on that. And obviously you could expand this house. If you do decide to remodel this, that might be kind of interesting to expand it and actually make it a decent sized house. Maybe this could just be the entranceway. I don't know. I don't know if anybody would be interested in doing that, but if you are ever interested, share it with me. And yeah, I mean, you can share anything with me, obviously, because I would love to see. I like seeing other people's builds and what they come up with. I think, it's, you know, everyone's super creative and I really like to see it. I have lots of fun with this whole building thing and The Sims. It's fun. Fun, 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 fun. I did a little ivy thing up the side. Thought that was kind of cute, and used those structure divider things. It's just kind of a decoration. And yeah, I was trying to make the outside look as interesting as possible since it is just a box. I mean, there's not too much you can do with a box, so a porch and some plants and a few decorative things like the awning that I have there with the holes in it. And I don't know, I tried to make it look nice and a little bit more interesting. So hopefully you guys like it, hopefully you guys think it's cute. And that I think the TV was glitching through the wall a little bit, and I didn't want to go in and mess with it, so I stuck the stuff in front of it. I was like, oh well, that's fine with me. And a little yoga mat out there so she can get some exercise and build some skills, since there's not too many, there's not really any skill building items in here. Besides the computer, obviously you can build skills on that, and I think you can watch the cooking channel to build cooking skill, but I mean, cooking builds your cooking skill, so I don't know. Yeah, there's not like an easel or a guitar or, you know, a chess table or anything like that, but obviously you could add all that kind of stuff out on the patio. You could extend the patio to make more room if you wanted to keep it a tiny home and still have activities and things outside. But I actually really like the landscaping on this house. With the, I've been really into the little, like, lavender bushes. I just think they're so, they're so pretty. I like them a lot. And they work really well with some other purpley bluish plants in the game too. It's nice. They complement each other. And it was requested that I do, I think I might have mentioned this before, that if I do some sort of a tutorial on landscaping, and I'm hoping to be able to do one, and hopefully my game will run smooth enough to where it won't be too big of a pain. So yeah, it's definitely something I have been thinking about. So yeah, if you are wanting to see that, don't worry, it's probably coming. I'm just trying to think of the proper way to do it so I can explain myself, because I don't think there's really a right way to landscape. There's many different ways to landscape. So I just have my way, and other people do it differently. And I think, yeah, I don't know. I don't know if there's a right way to do it. So I don't know if a tutorial or it's just kind of like a guide, like how I do it. I don't know. I don't know what I'm saying. But anyways, we're almost in screenshots. I took lots of pictures of the exterior because obviously the interior was very hard to take pictures of. So hopefully you guys enjoy this video, and please leave any comments or suggestions that you have, and I will talk to you guys soon. All right. Thanks for watching. Bye.